गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू गूगल क्लासरूम सपोर्टेड बाय श्री गोकुलम पब्लिक स्कूल गुरुवायूर। दिस इज अवर मैथमेटिक्स पीरियड एंड वी डील द चैप्टर 11 अलजेब्रा। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू नो व्हाट इज अलजेब्रा। व्हाट इज अलजेब्रा? अलजेब्रा इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स इन विच वी कैन यूज वेरिएबल्स ऑल्सो। So our next topic is solution of an equation. Solution means the value of the variable in an equation is called solution. Here we can consider this equation n plus 1 equal to 3. So dash plus 1 equal to 3. Which number plus 1 is 3? We know that 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. So we can substitute this n equal to 2. Okay, we can substitute n equal to 2. So here 2 is the solution of this equation. 2 is the solution of this equation. So we can write n equal to 2 is the solution. Next example, 2n equal to 10. Consider this equation, 2n equal to 10. Here equal symbol is there, one variable is there. So this is an algebraic equation. So we can solve this equation. 2n means 2 into n. 2 into n is equal to 10. 2 into which number is 10? 2 into 5 equal to 10. So n equal to 5. Here the solution is n equal to 5, or the value of n is 5. So we can write n equal to 5 is the solution. N equal to 6 is a solution? No, n equal to 6 is not a solution, because n equal to 6, if we substitute n equal to 6, we can write 2 into 6. 2 into 6 not equal to 10. 2 into 6 is 12. So the solution of the given equation 2n equal to 10 is n equal to 5. So you understood the solution of an equation. What is the solution? Solution means the value of the variable in the equation. Value of the variable in the equation is called the solution. Moreover, solving means finding the value of the variable. This process, here we found the value of the variable or the value of the unknown in the equation. This process is known as solving. What is solving? Solving means finding the value of variable in an equation. Okay, that process is known as solving. Next example, x minus 3 equal to 11. X minus 3 equal to 11. So 14 minus 3 is 11. So we can write x equal to 14 is the solution. If we substitute 14 for x, we will get the solution. Okay, so this equation is satisfied for the value x equal to 14. So x equal to 14 is the solution. This is the way we will find the solution for an equation. Here we introduce one method of solving. Its name is trial and error method. It means we will substitute 1, 2, 3, etc. for the variable in the equation and we find the solution. So we can do trial and error method by an example. 2n equal to 10. So here we are solving by substituting different values for n. First we will put n equal to 1. Then we are calculating 2 into n means 2 into 1, value is 2. Next we put n equal to 2. Then the equation becomes 2 into 2, that's equal to 4. Next, n equal to 3. 2 into n becomes 2 into 3, that is 6. N equal to 4. What is the value? 2 into 4, 8. N equal to 5. 2 into 5 is equal to 10. Then we got the value of n, because this 5 is satisfying the equation 2n equal to 10. So what we write here? N equal to 5 is the solution of 2n equal to 10. Understood? This method is known as trial and error method. Next question. Find the solution by trial and error method. X plus 2 equal to 6. This is the equation. How we will do? By substituting different values for x. From 1 we will put different values to the variable. So here first we write the equation x plus 2 equal to 6. What is our aim? Find the solution of this equation. Okay. So put x equal to 1. Then if this equation becomes 1 plus 2. What is the value of 1 plus 2? 3, not 6. So this is not a solution. Next we will substitute x equal to 2. Then this equation becomes 2 plus 2. 2 plus 2 equal to 4, not 6. Then x equal to 3. 3 plus 2 equal to 5. X equal to 4, we will get 4 plus 2. X plus 2 becomes 4 plus 2 equal to 6. So this is our required solution for this equation, because x plus 2 equal to 6 is the given equation. We got 4 plus 2 equal to 6. So x equal to 4 is the solution of the equation. So x equal to 4 is the solution of the given equation. So this method is known as trial and error method. But this method is not a direct and practical method. I told you. This process is known as solving. Finding the value of unknown is known as solving. And in the next year only you will learn the solving an equation by a systematic method. Okay, but you should know what is trial and error method. Okay, so you go through the notes and study well this method. Next year we will learn how we can solve the equations in a systematic way. That is very important chapter. Okay, solving an equation. Solving means finding the value of unknown, finding the value of variable. That is known as solving an equation. Here we write the term find the solution. Instead we will use solve the equation. Here we written find the solution by trial and error method. Okay, next year we will use the word solve an equation. What is solving? Finding the value of variable. Here the value of the variable is 4. So this is the solution. This process is known as solving the equation. That you will learn more in the next year. Okay. Children, let me conclude this topic by reminding you the words solution, the value of the variable, and solving, the process of finding the value of the variable in an equation. That process is solving. So, go through the notes and study well. Thank you, children. We can meet in the next session. Okay.